Thank you. After Arnab, it's difficult and very difficult. But Arnab has just left. I would congratulate him for the amazing Indians that he has brought to fore. I would start, I had a different presentation, but in the course of this entire summit and my morning with you, I had to reframe this entire thing and just put two very exciting things which the Department of Disability Affairs wishes to undertake, or rather is already in the process of taking up two experiments, two projects, if how much time do I have? I can go on and on like Arnab. How much time would I have? 15 minutes? 20 minutes? That's good enough. There are a lot of people from all around, quite a few Bangaloreans, quite a few from the other places all over the country. But it's my first opportunity outside Delhi, Mumbai, Calcutta, and Chennai to come to a place like Bangalore and speak on my department. So I would take some time to explain the department, because quite a few, particularly those who are young, wouldn't really know what exactly is the Department of Disability Affairs. I'll just spend 5 minutes on it. You have a tree here, right at the center, and I have a tree there in my department. And I just gave a comment in the morning that, well, your tree looks more beautiful, but I'll try to make my tree beautiful as yours. And this is the logo of the department. What a coincidence that the logo of the department that we chose about last year was Swavalamban, standing on your own feet, going forward, the strength, and the leaves, the various leaves, the different leaves all over the place. It's all part of the same tree, inclusion. So that is inclusion, that is Swavalamban, and that is where I start with Inclusion Summit. I would like to congratulate Mr. Nagari, all Preeti and everyone for having called me here. I would have been here yesterday, but Saturday is a good day to come and give lectures, and of course, I'm thankful to Enable India and SAP. Firoz, where is Firoz? Firoz is somewhere seeing off Arnab, but I'd just like to tell him, I read the other bestseller on the way to Bangalore. I was reading the Half Girlfriend, the book by Chetan Bhagat, and I can assure him, I'll be reading Gifted on the way back from Bangalore to Delhi, and that will be my contribution to the book. Swavalamban is what we chose for the Department of Disability Affairs. Next. How does it work? Yeah. These are details of the departments, but I would just like to put this. You can't see it. Well, let me see. Where do I start? I'll start here. The EDIP scheme. This is one scheme where I would like to tell you, I have a mobile phone, I have a smartphone, the Department of Disability Affairs. I'll just give you very few short examples because I would not like to get into the detail. The Department of Disability Affairs has now approved 53 devices to be given to students and persons with disabilities, and this device is for free with a keyboard. And a smartphone from Samsung India is what we have started to give on the 14th of November from the National Institute of Visually Handicapped. All institutions, all NGOs, all those who are working in this area of visual impairment should get in touch with me, my department, or the Department of Disability Affairs to ensure that we provide this device and enable those who require them. Believe me, there are millions of Indians who are poor, who are in the villages, who are in the rural areas, who are in small colleges and schools, who really don't have access, who really don't know. It's you who could provide information on these AIDS and assistive devices. We have this scheme of AIDS and assistive devices which runs all over the country. It can be provided to anyone whose family income is less than 15,000 rupees per month, which of course is sufficient to provide to a large number of students who are in schools and colleges. This is my first request to all of you, there are a large number of NGOs here who could possibly come back to us, arrange for camps, and we would like to arrange a camp at Bangalore through Enable India to at least reach at least 5 to 10,000 people in and around these places. The other issue that I'd like to state for the EDIP scheme would be that in the EDIP scheme, we provide a large number of items for the leprosy cured persons. Now, this is the very base of the pyramid. This is the very bottom of the pyramid. This is another area where we would like to get inputs from all those who are working in this area. The third area is hearing impairment, where we provide aids and assistive devices in the form of digital hearing aids. All those who could get in touch with beneficiaries who would require such digital hearing aids should come to us so that we can arrange for these aids and assistive devices. There is no limit to the numbers we can give. There is no limit to the places where we can go. We can go anywhere in the country. It's for us to get together to provide these things to them and to ensure that this is done. We also provide kits for mental impairment. Now, this kit also is the first time that we have approved mental impairment kits. Now, these kits can be given to students who require these kits. And this is, again, an area where a large number of NGOs are working. They could tie up with us. We have institutions all over the country. The first institution which is close to you is NIPMED at Chennai. And that is the institution, if you are familiar with them, you could get in touch with them. We have an institution called NIHH at Mumbai, which is in the hearing impairment area. You could get in touch with those people. You could get in touch with the people at NIMH, which is at Hyderabad or Secunderabad, which is in the area of mental impairment. These are the institutions which provide aids and assistive devices. The other scheme, of course, is for the SIBDA scheme, which provides for the government and semi-government organizations accessibility. We are in the process of formulating a program for accessibility, which will be somewhat in the area of toilets, accessible toilets, and all those aspects that need to come into the picture. This Abhiyan that we are undertaking to take up would be called Sugamya Bharat. Sugamya Bharat is what is the name we are proposing to give it. This formulation is also being taken up, and we're going to do it very fast. We provide incentives to employers for their statutory payments. There are a large number of employers here. I'm sure quite a few would not know how to get benefits of this scheme. Again, this is an area where we, with some inputs from Enable India, are in the process of reformulating this entire scheme to provide funds for those organizations who are employing persons with disabilities so that their contribution to the government can be reimbursed and subsidized by us. There are a large number of schemes for scholarships. Some students who are able to get to class 12th, it is usually found, particularly in the case of girls, that they are not able to go forward because they don't have the scholarship. There is a very simple scholarship scheme which is online. I am sure this scheme can help all those who want to take up higher education. There also is a scholarship scheme now for overseas scholarships. And the applications were on. I would require all of you to come to our website and see which are the scholarships which are available and then apply online. If there are people who would like to apply online and there are facilitators, there are people who are in this area, they could also help us to get the beneficiaries. The department, of course, has been created in May 2012. It's only 2 years old now, and it's a very young child. Of course, it has to go forward in a very fast fashion. I'm not going into the details, but I'll just put out some of the areas where we have undertaken to put the emphasis. What is the way forward? The way forward for us is to provide a universal identity card for all persons with disabilities, for creating a national database to provide an effective reach for all government benefits. I will give you a small presentation on this national database. The entire DPR is on our website. I had a few inputs from some of the organizations working all over the country. This is one area where I would like inputs from all of you of how to go about making a database. We are in the final process of finalizing the DPR. So if there are quality inputs, that is what we will undertake to put it in our own scheme. We also are going to start five new institutions: the Institute for Inclusive and Universal Design, the Institute for Sign Language and Research and Training Center, the National Institute of Mental Health Rehabilitation, and the Institute for Center for Disability Sports, and Braille Presses. For the Braille Presses, we have already launched a scheme in the country, and the scheme is already out. It's on the website of the department, as well as I think on the website of National Institute of Visually Handicapped. Those institutions are NGOs which are working in the area of visual impairment, and they have some basic Braille presses with them, could apply for the scheme and get almost about 2 crores for installing new Braille presses within their organizations. But those organizations should have had a track record of having worked in this area. Employment is a huge area where I am very happy that Enable India and SAP are working together. Employment is one area where a lot of work needs to be done. These initiatives will need to be taken up. What I would just like to tell you is, to hold any program in the area of awareness generation, the department has got a new scheme called the Awareness Generation Scheme. You please go online, see the website of the department. On a simple piece of paper with details of your organization of the last 3 years, your audit and annual reports, and some details of your organization, you could apply for the Awareness Generation Scheme, where we'll provide you funds for organizing such programs. And I can assure you on this day that the next India Inclusion Summit would be supported by the Department of Disability Affairs, and it will ensure that such effort, some small bit, would come from our department. We are also going to have, we just had a UNSCAP conference in Delhi on role of ICT, role of information and communication technology, which was supported by us. We are going to have a UNESCO conference in March on the 2nd and 3rd, which again will be on the UNCRPD. We have a Samarth, which is called, it's a diversity program for dances and music. This was held last year in February, and this year again we will hope to have it in March. So all organizations which have these cultural groups could come at our cost from anywhere in the country and perform on a common platform, so that we can provide a platform to such artists from the various places all over the, from all these states and from all parts of the country. Such performance will be welcome. Last year we had 99 groups of children who came from various parts, girls and boys, and they were provided a platform for showing their merit. And this is where a lot of effort can be taken up by you also. Maybe if the next Samarth is to be held, we could also have it in South India, and that is also a possibility. If there were a few leaders within the NGO sector who would like to take the initiative, please come forward. We will organize the next cultural platform for all children with disability at one place, say in Bangalore, Chennai, or any such place, or Trivandrum. We are also in the process of finalizing the first open para-national games. Arnab has just told you about Mrs. Deepa Malik. Deepa Malik is a good friend. We have just awarded her the National Award for the Role Model this year, which is going to be given on the 3rd of December. We are also now going to organize the first Para Games in Delhi with the Sports Department of the Government of India, where all para athletes will come together. Not going forward. Next. Can somebody help me? Yeah. It's it there. The universal ID. I'll just spend 3 minutes for the disability identification. What is felt all over the country, and this is an input and feedback from various sources, every person with disability, particularly this is seen in the rural areas, say in the northeast, say in some of the remote areas of the countries like Jammu Kashmir. There are places where persons with disabilities, girls, do not even come out of the house, leave alone taking them to a place where they could learn and they can be educated. So the Universal ID is an initiative of the department. Ernst & Young is our partner. We have almost finalized the DPR. I've just spoken to you about this. This entire DPR is on our website. This is what we will undertake to do. The Universal ID is a national database for persons with disabilities. We will issue an ID card which will have all the details of persons with disabilities, because if a disability certificate is issued by the Karnataka government and if the same person has to go to Delhi, maybe a college in Delhi will refuse it because they will say that you have to get it countersigned and a lot of chakkar is there for getting it all on board. If a disability card is issued by the government of Tamil Nadu and the person goes to the railways for getting the benefit, then the railways would refuse it and say that, well, you have to go to the railway doctor to get it verified. Now, all of these problems will get sorted out if we have a national database which is owned by the Department of Disability Affairs, so that every person with disability is able to come forth and get all the benefits and get an identity. It will be Aadhaar linked. The entire disability base will be Aadhaar linked. So I would request all the NGOs which are working in this sector, if you have persons with disability who are with you, who are working with you, or are in touch with you, should please enroll in the Aadhaar system so that the Aadhaar number and Aadhaar cards are there, because the Aadhaar will be the basis for providing the identification. The certificate, of course, will be monitored by us, tracked by us. There are some states which have done good work in this area. I am told Karnataka has some database, but quite a lot of that data is manual. Madhya Pradesh has a database which is in the soft copies. Maharashtra has a database. What we will do is collate all this database so that it all comes together. I will not go into the details, but this entire Universal ID card would have 18 digits. And this is the way we will do it is, the details of the residence of the person will be there, the details of the percentage of disability will be there, the details of the type of disability that is going to be, will also be there, so that the details are already available with us. You would already know that there are 19 disabilities which we have proposed to include in the new bill. This again is going to be a landmark. We have just had a meeting of the Standing Committee of the Parliament, where we have requested the Standing Committee of the Parliament to give its recommendation on the new bill so that it can be undertaken in the Raj Sabha and the Lok Sabha. 19 disabilities have already been included. If there are requests for more disabilities, the flexibility is there with us to include more disabilities within the new bill that is going to be undertaken. If there is any input, please give it to us as soon as possible. I have a lot of detail with me, which I will, of course, not take up. This is another point on which I would like to stress the awareness and the communication for issuance of the Universal ID. We would, at a point of time, come out in the public domain for requests from you to help us and to partner with us for the awareness generation to get the Universal IDs in place, to hold the camps where the Universal IDs would be issued to persons with disabilities. It is there where large number of you could partner with us, cooperative with us, so that we can get this all on board. And we are going to provide the funds for the awareness generation. It is you who have to come forth with your experience and your background to help us. There is another input on which I'll just spend another 2 minutes. This is an input where we are going to, this is going to be launched on the 3rd of December. This is an interactive website which we are going to launch on the AIDS and assistive devices which are available in the country. A large number of AIDS and assistive devices are now being developed by a large number of people, but we really do not have all of that information in one place. This website, which is called swavlamban.info, which will be our department's website in collaboration with the Department of Science and Technology, which will essentially get into the area of which are the type of aids and assistive devices which are present, what is that you can do in this area, where you can buy it, what is the approximate cost, what are the features, and what are the aids and assistive devices which are going to be developed in the country. So with this, I would like to say that, well, I have almost come to the end of my presentation. I had a lot here, but of course, it will take a lot of time. But I'm sure the two aspects of universal ID, the aspect of having an interactive website called Swavalamban, which will provide data on the aids and assistive devices, is what where we can all partner. I would just like to once again remind you that, well, the Department of Disability Affairs has got a large number of initiatives. What we require is a large number of partners like you who can come forth and help us to get these things going. The Department of Disability Affairs, is lot of it is advocacy driven, lot of it is driven through the support from the voluntary sector. It is you who can provide us all the support to take it forward. I would once again thank Enable India for giving me this platform to come to you. I thought these inputs would, of course, go a long way in getting things going. The department is on the job. We are a very small department, but we would like all the support from you. Thank you. I would also like to state that Firoz talked about his book being popular. We from the department will undertake to buy about 500 copies of this book so that it can be spread all over the country. 500 is the first chunk. I will try to ensure that we reach a number of 1,000. Depending on the institutions, we'll send it all over the country. It will be our job to provide this book to all and everyone, wherever we can provide it. Thank you. Jai Hind.
A disability now?
Yes, of course.
Thank you. It's really heartening to see how much the government is starting to do in the area of supporting the disabled becoming more productive members of society. And I really hope we can have a truly Sugamya India that is fully wheelchair accessible and that will support wheelchair accessibility in schools and colleges everywhere. Sir, I would like to...
I would like to just say one more line, that our minister for the Department of Disability Affairs, who is the Minister for Social Justice, mm-hmm. is a very proactive minister. We had very little time and the parliament session was on. Otherwise, we would have requested him to come all the way here to be part of the summit. We can plan something anywhere in India, wherever you would require, if it is planned in advance, and we would make a request. I'm sure he'll be part of you and he'll be with you so that we can take inputs and he can also understand the pulse of this sector. Thank you.
Thanks. I would like to invite Mr. Pranesh Nagri to please come forward to present the memento to sir.
I would just like...